Hi guys, in this tutorial I'm gonna talk about the anchor links scroll to, which was actually requested by one of the subscribers here. I think his name is BC. I hope I'm pronouncing the name right. Excuse me if I don't, but hopefully I am. So here we go. Let's talk about anchor links and see, understand it, this ability in prototyping, and let's see what we can do with it. Great, so let's get it going. So I created kind of like a, I don't know, website demo template. It doesn't really matter, honestly. I mean, it's just to show the prototyping ability. Of course, a website can be anything which fits your needs in your designs. Okay, of course it's gonna be with some title here and so on and so on. It's just kind of like, again, showing the ability of the scroll too. So we have this navigation bar, and the thing what I want to do actually is connect each one of them to link to a different layer. Actually, we are linking to different layers in our screen, in our frame, in the frame that is holding all of this content, okay? So instead of just, let's duplicate it for a minute. So instead of me clicking on, let's say, the first navigation option and going into prototype mode and then just connecting it to a different frame, okay, which is this one, the next screen. So I'm actually connecting it to a layer inside this page. The moment I do that, see that here, one second, let me make my UI a bit bigger. Yeah, so it would be possible to see it better. Yeah, exactly. So see that when I connect this arrow, this link arrow, to another layer inside my screen, it opens the ability to scroll to. That means that when I click this link, it's gonna scroll into this layer, actually this section, this part of our page. Okay, it doesn't matter actually if it's mobile or web. So let's hit the play and just see what it does. Let's say that I will connect this one, okay, to the first one, and I will connect, one second, it kind of fights with me. So yeah, it didn't let me click on it. So this is gonna be for the second one and the third one and so on. I'm just gonna link it to each one below. It's not all the way to the end, but that's okay. We get the general idea. Okay, so let's, yeah, link it to here, and I have some more sections here which now it doesn't really matter. Okay, it's just to understand the logic and the principle of how to work with it. So let's just hit the play right now. By the way, notice that it's without any animation to it, and we will add the animation as we go. So I'm gonna hit the play. And another thing, I made this bar, by the way, in a fixed position, okay, and gave its background a bit of opacity, that when we scroll and the header stays on the top, we're gonna see a bit of the content scrolling underneath it, below it. Okay, so let's see how it goes. Let me put it in a fit width, and I'm gonna actually make this UI go away now because we don't need it. So if I click on, let's say, this one, boom, it brings me immediately to the layer that we connected to. Of course, it looks quite crappy right now, but we're gonna fix it in a sec. And this is linking to here, and that's linking to here, and this is linking back to here. Okay, so basically, technically speaking, it's working, but of course not in the way that probably we would want it to work. So let's see how to adjust it correctly. Okay, so I'm going to click it and give it an animate. First of all, it's going to be not an instant movement or just pass instantly to that or jump instantly, more right to say, to the layer that we are connected to. Animate, let's give it a, I think 400 milliseconds. I think it's okay. We can always adjust it if we need to. And I'm gonna do it with all the rest quickly. Animate 400. Yeah, I'm doing it really quick. I'm doing it really quickly. And yeah, okay. Good. So now we have it with animation, and let's see how it works. Okay, now it looks much better, but still we have kind of a problem. The problem is, if you will notice, that when I'm linking to this layer, it jumps to the top of the file. Okay, just like to the top of the frame, actually. And it doesn't look very well, and probably in a lot of cases, this is not what you really want to do with that. I mean, you want this layer, for example, to scroll up to here, okay? Up to this point and see the header clearly and not have it kind of like stuck underneath the layer, okay? So how can we adjust it? What I'm doing is usually, if I wanted to link, but give me this space, let's say, of the header, of course, it's just example, which is with good context to what's happening on the screen. Now, in other screens or other needs, it can be completely different. But see how I'm kind of calculating it. So I'm drawing a rectangle, something like that. If I want this layer, let me just take it out of the frame. Yeah. So if I want this layer, any layer, sorry, not this one, but any layer to scroll up to this point more or less. Okay. I'm going into the design now. The height is 126. Let me give it 120 just to make it round. Okay, cool. So I know that the height that I need to give the space up here is 120 pixels. So going back to prototype and look what I'm doing now. Here I have a Y offset. The offset means that I can give a minus pixel or a plus pixels to the point where I want it to scroll to when this is my zero position. My zero position when scrolling to any layer is the beginning of the layer. If I wanted to scroll 120 pixels less than the point of than the Y position of this layer, actually, so I need to give it a Y offset of minus 120 pixel. Of course, if I give it a plus, it's gonna link to this layer, scroll to this layer, plus 120 pixels, meaning up to here, something like that. And of course, I mean, if this is what you want and that's what you need, great then. But if you don't, then now you know how to adjust it. So let's see what happens now. Let's give all of them minus 120. Let me just copy that. Okay, so now I think we're all set. We have it going. And now when I will scroll to a layer, you see, now we have it positioned in a right way, exactly as we wanted to navigate. Super. Okay, I think it's quite understandable and straightforward. Here, by the way, I'm scrolling. I need to give it more because this is the frame. Okay, but the title actually is above it. So let's see if I wanna fix it. So the frame that is holding all these testimonials is up to here. I give it minus 120, which looks like that, but it's not enough. So we need to give it, let's say, I guess around, 1 second, yeah. So we need to give it, this is the one that links to it. So let's give it a minus, 160, I think, 80. Let's see what happens. Minus 180. So let's go to here and to here. Okay, almost. And we need like another 20 pixels and we're good. So that was a good example how to adjust where it scrolls to. So it scrolls to this layer minus 180 pixels, which is not enough in this case. We need to give it a bit more space, but that's okay. So the only thing is just to understand how it works. Okay, great. Now let's see another example. I made these illustrations just before the tutorial because I didn't want to waste time of doing it now and just gave it kind of like an example and see how to work with it. So we have these three frames which are holding, actually each one of them holds an illustration. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to connect all these frames, or actually hook up all these frames in another frame which will hold them. You know what? We don't even need to make it an outside frame. I mean, I can do this frame just here. That's going to be just more simple, I guess. This is, let me see, that is 320 height. And this is, let's give it a 340 height, which is good. And this is 330. That is going to be 330 as well. Okay, that's okay. Actually, that's fine. I'm kind of like fighting with myself. Yes, no, yes, no. That's okay. Okay, so this frame, actually, let's call it illustrations, and that's okay. Let's give it a, I think, 10 pixels round, and let's give it a fill, which is going to be a bit lighter than this one. Let's do it something even like that, and a bit lighter. That's good. And I will give it also a stroke, which is going to be the same color as this one, but a bit darker. Okay, something like that. Good. Okay. So what I'm going to do now, actually, is I'm going to take these illustrations. I will move them here. I will just copy them and put it here, something like that. Good. It's not good yet, but it's going to be good because we're gonna put it in the illustration frame. So now let me select all three of them, and let me take this one, and one second, lollipop. Oh, that has a lollipop love, and that has a cigar love. Let me see. Ah, okay, it's just showing me the ones above as well, on top as well. So let me take this one, and this one. Okay, I'm gonna X and just paste it inside this frame. Okay, good. So we have something like that, which, of course, these three illustrations are inside this frame. I'm gonna deselect the clip content on this and on the screen, and now we're gonna see these illustrations actually outside this frame and the frame of the screen that holds it. Now this button, going back to the prototyping, is gonna link to this layer. Okay, this is going to be animate 400 milliseconds. I think it's okay. Scroll to, and that is good. Okay, and let me see, this one actually is gonna link to this layer. Scroll to, great. And this one is going to link to the lollipop layer. Okay, so let's see how it works now. So I'm just explaining again, this is a frame. These three illustrations are inside this frame, okay, which holds them. we have a button outside this frame which is linking to each one of these layers. Actually, each frame is actually a layer. Okay, let's hit the play and nothing happens. Why is that? Let me see. Let me hit the play. Oh, I know why nothing happens. Okay, I forgot to do something. Exactly. Yeah, this is something which I forgot. And of course, without that, it can't work. This frame, we need to give it an overflow scrolling of horizontal scrolling in this case, by the way. Okay, horizontal scrolling. And now we can have it working, because without that, it's not going to work. Oh, yes, that is good. Of course, we have to, I have to turn on the clip content again to not see it kind of like scrolling outside here. So I can go back, hit the clip content here, which here actually is enough. Yeah, that's okay. And, okay, great. This is really, really nice. Okay, so with scroll too. Great, you can do really nice stuff with scrolling inside areas with outside buttons which are actually taking care of it. You can do the same, for example, with a map. You can do a big map and kind of like put scrolling areas on it, and just when I click on each back in on each button, it can take me, let's say, to some location on the map. It's actually, you can take this frame and give it on the overflow scrolling, you can give it horizontal and vertical scrolling, and then you can just go inside this frame to wherever you want. So that's pretty cool. Okay, nice, I like that. It's cool. Okay, guys, so I think that basically, you know, it wasn't a long tutorial. I think it's quite understandable. If you have any questions and you think that maybe I should show something more, anything you like, just write to me. Of course, no problem. I think that basically that's about it. So bye for now, guys. See you in the next tutorial. I would love a like if you like this tutorial, and if you subscribe to my channel, I would be very happy as well, of course. Comment if you need to on anything, and thank you so much for watching. See you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.